They lived far away from each other during the school year, but every summer they were bunkmates at Camp Massad. As the weather got warmer and flowers started to bloom, David and Elliot always looked forward to reuniting at the camp bus stop. Reuniting means getting back together again when you haven't seen somebody in a long time. So they always look forward to reuniting at the camp bus stop. When David and Elliot arrived at camp, they made sure to get beds next to each other in their bunk. And when they played sports, they always wanted to be on the same team. They were very good friends. One Sunday, David and Elliot walked together to morning prayers. David brought a safety pin with him from the bunk. Everybody at camp had safety pins to keep their dirty socks together in the laundry. The safety pins kept the socks in pairs so that none of them got lost. When clothes came back from the laundry, the socks were clean and still pinned together. The safety pins were sparkling clean too. During morning prayers, David took the safety pin out of his pocket and started to play with it. First, he opened and closed the safety pin. Then, he started to rub the safety pin against his cheeks. A few minutes later, David put the safety pin in his mouth and started sucking on it as if it were candy. Elliot knew that putting a safety pin in your mouth is very dangerous, but he was so caught up in the singing that he didn't notice what David was doing. Suddenly, David tapped Elliot on the shoulder. Elliot turned and saw that David's eyes were tearing up and his face looked a bit pale. Do you know what pale means? Anyone else? Pale is when your face doesn't look like its normal color. It gets a little bit lighter because you're a little bit scared. So Elliot turned and saw that David's eyes were tearing up and his face looked a bit pale. David, what's wrong? Elliot asked. David was so scared he could barely speak. I think I swallowed the safety pin, David whispered. You think you swallowed the safety pin? Elliot screamed. Well, actually, I'm sure I swallowed the safety pin, David cried. Holy moly, Elliot said. We'd better go tell a grown-up right away. Is that a good idea?
Yes.
Yeah, that's a good idea. We'd better go tell a grown-up right away. Elliot and David hurried to the back of the social hall to tell their counselor what had happened. Is everything okay, guys? Asked the counselor. David just swallowed a safety pin, Elliot said. He what? Asked the counselor. David swallowed a safety pin, Elliot replied. You can't swallow a safety pin. A safety pin isn't food, said the counselor. I know that, but he did, Elliot shouted. Holy cannoli, said the counselor. We need to go to the infirmary right away. The infirmary is a place at camp where there's a nurse and a doctor. That's what it is. David, Elliot, and the counselor quickly walked to the infirmary. As they got closer, they saw Rebecca, the camp mother, standing on the porch. The camp mother is kind of like a nurse and somebody who takes care of you at sleepaway camp. How are you boys feeling on this beautiful day, she asked. My friend David just swallowed a safety pin, Elliot said. He what? Asked the camp mother. David swallowed a safety pin, Elliot replied. You can't swallow a safety pin. A safety pin isn't food, said the camp mother. I know that, but he did, Elliot shouted. Holy ravioli, said the camp mother. We need to go see the camp doctor right away. David, Elliot, and the camp mother marched into the infirmary and found their way to the doctor's office. How y'all doing? Dr. Emanowitz asked with a southern accent, even though he was from Brooklyn. Do you know what an accent is? Like an accent, people who come from different places speak with different accents. So if I went to Georgia, people would think that I have a New York accent. If somebody came here from Georgia, they'd say, hey, how you all doing, right? You would think that they have a southern accent because they're from Georgia. So how you all doing, Dr. Ohana was asked with a southern accent, even though he was from Brooklyn. My friend David just swallowed a safety pin, Elliot said. He what? Asked the doctor. David swallowed a safety pin, Elliot replied. You can swallow a safety pin. A safety pin isn't food, said the doctor. I know that, but he did, Elliot shouted. Holy minestrone, the doctor said. We need to get David to the hospital, pronto. You know what pronto means? Pronto means right away. We need to get David to the hospital, pronto. I'll have Rocky, the camp driver, take us there. Rafi sped to the hospital as fast as the law allowed. As everybody piled out of the car, a nurse greeted them. Welcome to Allentown Hospital, said the nurse. What seems to be the problem? My friend David just swallowed a safety pin, Elliot said. He what? Asked the nurse. David swallowed a safety pin, Elliot replied. You can't swallow a safety pin. A safety pin isn't? Said the nurse. I know that, but he...
Yeah.
Elliot shouted. Holy macaroni, said the nurse. We need to get David to the radiologist right away. David sat down in a wheelchair. The nurse pushed him into the elevator and quickly pressed the B button. B is for basement. As the elevator descended toward the basement, descended means to go down, right? So if you're on the main floor and you're going to a basement, you're descending. You're going down. As the elevator descended toward the basement, David asked, what's a radiologist? A radiologist is a special kind of doctor who takes pictures of your insides to know what's going on and help you get better, Dr. Ohana was explained. Has anybody ever been to a radiologist? Like if you broke your arm or something like that?
Once when I was a baby, I had to
So a radiologist is a special kind of doctor who takes pictures of your insides to know what's wrong and helps you get better, said Dr. Monowitz. When the elevator doors opened, everybody raced to the doctor's office. What can I do for you young gentlemen, the radiologist asked. My friend David just swallowed a safety pin, Elliot said. He what? Asked the radiologist. David swallowed a safety pin, Elliot replied. You can't swallow a safety pin. A safety pin isn't?
Yeah.
Said the radiologist. I know that, but he...
Yeah.
Holy rigatoni, said the radiologist. We need to take some x-rays so we know what's going on. After studying the x-rays for a few minutes, the radiologist said, David, I was afraid that you would need an operation today and would have to stay in the hospital for a long time. Luckily, the safety pin is in your stomach and it's closed, so it should come out in a few days. However, if the safety pin doesn't come out in 5 days, you'll need to come back to the hospital to have more tests. But how will I know if the safety pin comes out? David asks. Well, David, the radiologist explained, after you go to the bathroom, you'll need to look inside the toilet bowl to see if the safety pin came out. Yuckity, yuck, 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 David shouted in unison. Do you know what in unison means? In unison means like when you say things at the same time. So let's try to say yuckity, yuck, yuck, yuck in unison when I count to three, okay? One, two, three.
Yuckity, yuck, yuck, yuck.
That was excellent. We all did that in unison. That was really good. David and Elliot thanked everybody for their help and happily headed back to camp. Although he was not excited about the doctor's advice, David understood that he'd need to follow it if he wanted to get better. He felt relieved that he would be okay as long as the safety pin came out. So every day, David carefully followed the doctor's instructions and looked into the toilet bowl, hoping to see the safety pin. On Monday, David stared into the toilet bowl, but he didn't see the safety pin. On Tuesday, David felt discouraged, like he's a little sad, when again, he saw no sign of the safety pin. On Wednesday, David started to worry that he might have to go back to the hospital for more tests. But on Thursday, when David looked into the toilet bowl, he saw the safety pin floating in the middle of the bowl. Eureka, David shouted, as all his bunkmates let out a big cheer. You know what Eureka means? Eureka means, you say Eureka when you're happy that you found something that you're looking for, that you haven't been looking for, you couldn't find it, but then you found it, you say Eureka. So let's try to say Eureka together in unison when I count to three. One, two, three.
Eureka!
Okay. So when I say Eureka, I like to say it with a fist pump, because like you're really, really happy. So let's try to do it once more time with a fist pump when I count to three, okay? One, two, three.
Eureka!
I found it. It's like when you're looking for your favorite toy and you haven't been able to find it, and then you find it. That's like a Eureka moment. So, Eureka, David shouted, as all his bunkmates let out a big cheer. On the last day of camp, David and Elliot boarded the bus to go back home. They were sad that the summer was over, but they were looking forward to seeing their families. While sitting next to each other on the back of the bus, David told Elliot that every summer, he learns a lot of important new things at summer camp. The most important thing I learned this summer is that it's not safe to put anything in my mouth that isn't food. Holy guacamole, Elliot said, I thought you already knew that. Did you guys already know that?
Yeah.
Okay, well now you know that. That's why I was asking not to put that.